Hey, what's up, guys? It's Gathalion, and welcome back to How to Twitch. In this series, I like to show you how to stream to twitch.tv, and today I'm going to go over the software that I use to stream personally. I use OBS, or Open Broadcast Software. You can get it for free. I believe it's obsproject.whatever, but if you search OBS or Open Broadcast Software on Google, you'll find it very easily. I'll put a link in the description below. Can't think of it right now. Anyways, so I'm gonna go over the settings that I use for not only recording but encoding, also streaming. So we're gonna start off with the encoding tab. Right now I have it set to 20,000 kilobytes per second, which is too high for Twitch. What you want to do is you want to set it to about 3500, and that's if you're partnered. Here's the reason. 3500 bit rate is the maximum that Twitch will allow you. Now, as a beginner, you don't have encoding on Twitch. So unfortunately, you won't be able to have people who could set it to low or set it to medium or set it to higher source. So you need to accommodate for these people who cannot watch your streams. So I'm going to recommend you set it around 1500 to maybe even 2000. Maybe 2000, but to get the most people who are able to watch your stream, setting it around 1500 max bitrate is probably the smartest thing you can use. Use the CBR, that's constant bitrate. That'll ensure that there won't be any fluctuations in bitrate between you and Twitch, which can give you a poor signal to them. I also use the X264 encoder. That is your CPU encoder. If you prefer to use the NVIDIA encoding, I have noticed that it doesn't look quite as good as CPU encoding, especially if you have a nice CPU like an i7. If you're still rocking like an i3, you might want to try out the NVIDIA codec, but you need to have a Kepler or above card if you're trying out the NVIDIA encoder, because the Kepler and above actually have that onboard video encoder for them, and Fermi to the past do not. So if you have like a 600 series and above for NVIDIA, you can use that NVIDIA codec. And if you have an AMD card, then obviously you can't use the NVIDIA codec. Audio bit rate, obviously you can push out some good audio. I tend to sit around 96 through 112, 48 kilohertz, yada yada. Stereo, blah. Okay, moving on. Broadcast settings. Right now, I'm doing file output only, but you could set it to live stream. Obviously, you're going to put your stream key here. You pick that up off of Twitch. You go to your dashboard. You hit stream key, and it will give you a stream key. You can usually try to broadcast to whatever server is nearest to you. I usually go in between Florida and Ashburn, Virginia. I am in Florida, but for whatever reason, I have issues with the Miami server, which is a little bit weird. So that is my broadcast settings. We're gonna go down to video. All right, so down in the video settings, we do have, actually, let's set this back. I don't think that's gonna fuck with me right now. I don't think those take until the next launch, but anyways. So, video adapter, I'm using a GTX 980, custom resolution 1920 by 1080, and I do not recommend trying to stream at 1920 by 1080, so you will mostly be capturing 1080p signals, so you're gonna have to downscale those. So I use a resolution downscale of 1.5, which brings it to 720p, which is the optimal streaming resolution, and I tend to use a Lankzos, best detail 36 samples. Of course, this is a little bit tougher on your encoding process, and I usually stream at 30 or 60 frames per second depending on the game that I am currently streaming. Audio is where things get a little bit maybe complicated for me. My camera is delayed, and I think it's due to some USB controller issues, so hopefully that won't be an issue much longer, because I am getting a new PC with top-of-the-line USB controller on it. Right now I think I have like Aztec or something, I don't know, Azmedia. Yeah, Azmedia, and I'd rather an Intel controller on it. Anyways, so my mic off sync is 300 milliseconds to match with my camera, so that I'm not looking like I am being voiced over. Mic boost, desktop boost, this is all up to you. Depends on how much louder you want your mic or your desktop audio. The thing about how audio works on OBS is any audio you could hear over your desktop, you will also hear, or your audience will hear through OBS. So let's say that you're playing music that will be heard through your stream if you're listening to music. If anything plays on Chrome or Firefox or Internet Explorer, those sounds going over your desktop will go over OBS. So keep that in mind when opening any sort of audio files. I'm not big on hotkeys. Moving on to advanced, I use multi-thread optimizations. Priority class, I usually sit it at normal. I use a very fast X264 CPU preset. You can make your stream look a little better if you use faster or fast, but I sit it on very fast because that's what OBS recommends. They recommend you use the main encoding profile. I've never really had issues with high, but they recommend main, so you should probably hit it there. And a key interval at 2. Moving down, you don't have to allow this. This is just something that I've done for making videos in the past and slowing down the frame rate. And so that pretty much, oh yeah, latency tuning 20. These are all my settings that I've used for a long time. They actually recommend 700 to your scene buffering time, but I usually have it set at 400. So these are the settings that I use, guys. Hopefully you have found this to be helpful. I know a lot of people have asked for like optimal OBS settings, but honestly, a lot of this will really depend on your system, your stream, what game you're streaming, you know, what frame rate you are streaming at. This is all relevant information, but hopefully I've given you guys a little bit of a heads up for what you should do in the future. Again, that 3500 is the maximum that you should really stream at for Twitch. So cool, guys. That'll about wrap it up. Hopefully this has helped you out. Don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you back inside of How to Twitch. Yay!